Did you know your iPhone could do that? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you a few more things that you might not know your iPhone can do, so let's talk about it. What's up, people? This your boy, Viper, the man about tech, back again for the video. And yes, your iPhone keypad can become a trackpad, and this makes it insanely easy when you're texting people and you made a mistake in the text and you want to go back and correct it. All you got to do is just press and hold on the space key. It has to be the space key because that's where this function is activated. But once you press and hold on that space key, you can move the cursor to anywhere in the message that you want. And that way you can make corrections definitely legit. Speaking of the iPhone keyboard, one of the most annoying things about it is that there is no dedicated caps lock button. But what if I told you if you double tap on the shift key, boom, you have a caps lock button. Sticking with the iPhone keyboard and iMessage in particular, did you know that you can make your iMessages a little more fun, a little more lively? And the way that you do that is you type out whatever message that you want, but instead of pressing the arrow key to send it, press and hold on the arrow key. If you do that, you will be presented with bubble and screen effects. Now, bubble effects, you got slam, you got loud, you got gentle, you got invisible ink. So let's go and choose slam, right? So we choose slam, boom, and then everything gets slammed down like a slam dunk in a basketball, but it's happening in your iMessage. So let's go back and try that again, type some stuff, go back, press and hold on the arrow, and then let's look at the screen effects. And then you got the different screen effects. You got the echo effect. So if you swipe to the left, you can go through the different effects. You got spotlight. You got balloons. You have confetti. You have love. Lasers. Ooh, lasers. You got fireworks, my personal favorite. What else we got? We got celebration. Ooh, yeah. And that's about it. So let's go back and send fireworks. So if you hit the arrow on the fireworks screen, woo! Your iMessages got a little bit more 4th of July if you smell what the vibe is cooking.
Stop! Yes, I'm talking to you. You're not subscribed to my channel yet, are you? Because according to my statistics, only 11% of y'all watching these videos are subscribed to the channel. So if you want more of this Apple goodness, I need you to go down there, hit that white subscribe button, and probably glowing right now if you're watching on iPhone or iPad. So go down there and hit it and join the man about tech.
Now, one of the more mundane tasks that we have to do sometimes as adults is scan documents. Now, back in the day, you had to have a dedicated document scanner to do something like this, but not anymore with your iPhone. So if you want to scan a document to your iPhone, open up the Notes app, right? So if you open up the Notes app and start a new note, you can see at the top row of the keyboard, there's a camera icon. If you click on the camera icon, there will be a few options presented to you. And one of those options is to scan documents. So if you press that, it will open up your camera. And then you just hover your iPhone over the document, and then it will automatically scan that document into your Notes app. If you save it, it'll go into your Notes app, or if you don't like that particular scan, you can rescan it again. Speaking of handy things with your iPhone, did you know that your iPhone has a search aggregator called Spotlight? So if you're on your iPhone's home screen, or even you can do this on the lock screen as well, just do a quick swipe down from the middle, and that will open up Spotlight. So at the top here, you got three suggestions. It gives you the option to make a new note, or you could type something in the search bar. Let's type in milk, right? So if I type in milk, it gives me, I can search for milk on the web. That's what that Safari icon means. It gives me maps to places that have the name milk in it. There's a bunch of things going on here, website, movies, everything to do with milk. So that's a cool little thing that your iPhone can do. So back in the day, iPhones used to have a feature called 3D Touch. And basically, it was you long pressing on an app and bringing up some app shortcuts and other functionality. But Apple kind of got rid of that feature, but it still kind of lives somewhat. There are still app shortcuts. So instead of just tapping an app and having the app open, if you tap and hold on the app, you will be presented with a few shortcuts of things that you can do in that particular app. So if I tap and hold on YouTube here, I have the option to remove the app. You can remove it from the home screen, or you can delete it depending on what you which option you choose on the next screen. You can share the app, edit the home screen. You can create, you got subscriptions, search, and short. So those are just some of the things that you can do in the YouTube app. Now, this next one is a little known feature on iPhone, but you know, when you want to rearrange app icons on iPhone, you have to press and hold until they all jiggle and then you just move the app around to whatever page that you wanted. But did you know that it's possible to move more than one app at a time with this method? I know. It requires two hands, though, so which makes it a little bit cumbersome, but it can happen. What you want to do is tap and hold with the one app, on the one app, and then tap any other app that you want to move at the same time. So I'm going to go to another page here and do this. So again, hold the app that you started to hold originally, and then just tap app that you want to include in that move. And then you can remove those apps or reshare those apps to any page. This next trick is something that's been on iPhone since the beginning of time, at least in my opinion, but you may or may not know it exists. So let's say you're on an app like Twitter, right? And you know with Twitter, you can scroll and keep scrolling and keep scrolling and different things like that. But what if you want to get back to the top of your timeline on Twitter? Now, there's a couple of options here. You can hit the home icon on the bottom that will accomplish the feat. Also, but a known iPhone trick is to tap the top of the screen or the top of your iPhone, excuse me, and tapping the top of your iPhone will take you all the way back to the top. It's almost like teleportation back to the top, just like that. So, you know, if you open up the control center and tap on the flashlight icon, assuming you have the flashlight in your control center, it turns on your flashlight. But did you know that you could control the level of brightness in which your flashlight emits? So if you tap and hold on the flashlight icon in the control center, you can change the level of the brightness of the flashlight just like that. Let me see. Boom. Okay, now this next one is especially useful if you're traveling and let's say you're staying at a hotel or you're in a public place like a library or a Starbucks or something and you need internet. And let's say you have multiple devices, right? Let's say you have your iPhone and your iPad, but your iPad, maybe it's a Wi-Fi only iPad. It doesn't have a cell signal in it like your iPhone. You can use your iPhone as a hotspot, an internet hotspot for your iPad or any other device that has internet connectivity. So what you want to do with your iPhone, you want to go into settings and then click on personal hotspot and then turn it on where it says allow others to join. You want to click that on to yes. You can set your own Wi-Fi password. And then down at the bottom here, you can read which network will present itself when you are trying to attach another device to your iPhone. So once you go into something like your iPad or you have a computer there that needs internet access, you go into your network and then your iPhone should show up as a network that you can connect to. You will click on that network. You'll have to put in the network password and then you will be able to use the internet on your iPhone, on your iPad or laptop. You know, every now and then, I need to show somebody visually how to do something, whether that be do something on their phone or show them a website or something to go to. And sometimes that requires me to do a screen recording of my iPhone, basically recording the things that I'm doing on my iPhone in real time. So how you do that, at least for me anyway, I scroll down to my control center and then you click on this little icon with the circle. We're in the middle of a circle. And then you get a countdown at the top here, 3, 2, 1. And then now my iPhone will literally record everything that I do on the screen. So it has the recording of the Instagram notification that just dropped down. I don't know. You guys don't see that probably. It also can record the me swiping up and down Twitter. If I swipe back to the home screen, it records that. So everything that I'm doing on my phone or that you do on your phone will be recorded once you hit the screen record button. And then when you're done, you just go up to the dynamic island, tap stop. And then you can access that screen recording in your Photos app and send it to somebody. Something else that's useful with your iPhone that you might not know about is changing the default email and web browsing app. Obviously, given that it's an iPhone, it's going to default to Apple app for the email and the web browser, which means the default web browsing app on here is going to be Safari. The default emailing app is going to be the Apple Mail app, which I hate with a passion. I am a Gmail user. So if you're like me and you're a Gmail user, you can change the default email app on here to Gmail. So anytime you click on a Gmail link online or in a text message, it will open up a Gmail and not the Apple Mail app. But how do you do that, you might say? Basically, you want to go into settings. And once you go into settings, you want to go to the Gmail app settings down here in your grouping of apps. And once you find Gmail, you're going to click on it. And then it says default mail app. You're going to click on that. And make sure yours is selected to Gmail. You do this the same way for changing the default browser. So we go back out here and we go to Chrome because I have Chrome installed and I want that to be my default browser. I click on Chrome and then I go to the default browser app and I change it to Chrome if I want to make Chrome my default browser. And that way, when you open up any website link, They will open up automatically in Chrome instead of Safari. The last tip is probably the most important tip that I could tell you in this video, and it has to do with if anything were to happen to your iPhone, let's say it freezes, you got an app that's not running properly, or something that's not working properly, or whatever the case may be. This is a quick fire way to troubleshoot your iPhone. And what you want to do is you want to quickly, and I mean quickly, press volume up, volume down, press and hold the power button until the Apple logo appears. Once the Apple logo appears, you can release the power button, and that will do a soft reset of your iPhone. Now, to be clear, doing this soft reset does not lose you any data. It just basically clears out all the information and processing that the iPhone is currently undergoing. So basically, it's like starting your iPhone from fresh. So I know a lot of you all just got new iPhone for Christmas. So I made a video detailing the first 10 things or more that you should do with your new iPhone. So you can check out that video right there.